The fifth problem, he is instructing us to prepare machinery account. So let us discuss briefly something what machinery account is all about. So whenever we have some machinery, we buy it, some machines we sell, further we make some additions, etc. So all these transactions, purchasing to the purchase and sale of an asset, we record in this machinery account. So machinery is basically an asset. So we will be preparing machinery account, so we have to be careful here. We have to select those transactions of which are related to machinery only. If any other transactions are given, we are going to ignore them. Now, on 1st March, purchased machinery from Vikram and Company. Machinery being a set, real account, we debit it. So our journal entry would be machinery account debit. Since it is not stated, we paid for it or not, and the name of the organization is given, we are treating it as a machinery purchased on credit, and hence we are crediting Vikram and Company. So the entry would ultimately become machinery account debit to Vikram and Company account. So that means machinery account should be debited. So in the ledger, an account is to be debited means we enter the amount on the debit side. So 42,000 we are entering on the debit side of machinery account. As you know that 2 is a constant on the debit side in the particulars, the reason Vikram and Company is supplying this. The date being 1st March 2014. Now, let us see the second transaction. On 6th, machinery purchased from Virat. Machinery purchased from Virat. Again, it is the same machinery account debit to Virat's account. So on 6th, we have purchased again one more machine from Virat for a value of 16,000. Debit machinery account with 16, 2 constant on the debit. Here the reason we have purchased from Virat. Now, let us see the transaction on 12th. Machinery costing 8,000, sold for 5,000. So, we have some machinery with us now. In this, some machines we are selling. So, when we say when we are buying machinery, machinery is coming in. Similarly, when we are selling away that machinery, machinery is going out. So, machinery being real account, when it goes out, when we are selling, we have to credit it because it goes out. So our entry would be first cash. We have to debit because when we sell machinery, naturally we get cash. Cash account debit. Since machinery is going out, we have to credit the machinery based on the real account rule. So now we have to credit the machinery account. So in machinery account, we will enter this amount on the credit side. How much did we get? 5,000. So first we will write 5,000. By being constant, this 5,000 we are getting cash. So the reason is cash, and the date being 12th. Now if you carefully read the transaction, we are also given the cost of the machinery. If you see, the cost of the machinery is 8,000. The cost of the machinery is 8,000, and we sold it for how much? We sold it for 5,000. That means here we are incurring a loss of 3,000. So we have to record this loss also in the machinery account, since here there is 8,000 worth of machinery which is on the debit side, which we are selling away for 5,000. When 8,000 is there on the debit, we have to remove the total 8,000 when we are selling it. So we have already removed 5,000 by way of cash. So we have to remove 3,000 by way of loss. So our journal entry, here it is loss on sale of machinery. So we can say P&L account debit, because ultimately the loss would be transferred to P&L account. We can use the word P&L, so which is to machinery account. Your narration, if at all you want to know, would be being loss on machinery sold. Now, taking this, we have to credit the machine with 3000, which is loss actually. Then buy is a constant. You can write by P&L, or alternatively, you can use loss on sale of machinery. It is an alternative. Okay, so that the choice is between how you are taught. Next, on 16th, it states that depreciation provided on machinery. Now, before recording this depreciation or transaction rather, we will discuss what is depreciation. Now, in accounting terminology, depreciation is one of the kind of expense. Now, what is depreciation? Why it is an expense? Now, depreciation means it is gradual and a permanent decrease in the value of an asset over a period of time due to its usage. That is, whenever we use our assets, their value decreases because of usage as the time passes. So, the asset, let us say you have a car with you which is worth 1 lakh. You used it for 1 year. After 1 year, your engineers or experts valued it at 90,000. So that means the value of your car has decreased by 10,000 because you used it. So this decrease in value of an asset due to its usage, or there are several other factors which you will learn in detail in a chapter called depreciation later. So due to usage, the value of your asset has come down by 10,000. So this 10,000 is called as depreciation, and it is an expense. Now, why depreciation is an expense? Basically, you have studied the definition of expense in the initial chapters. What is expense? Expense is the expired value of expenditure. What is expenditure? Expenditure means when you have spent an amount and you got something for it. So naturally, when you have machinery with you, you would have spent the amount when you purchased it. So the value of that machine at that point of time is called expenditure. So that expenditure value has completely disappeared, or we say you have used it up. So what is expense? Used up value of expenditure. So the used up value of our asset is how much given in the problem? It is given as 3000. So when the value of the asset is used up, and which we call it as depreciation, depreciation being expense has to be debited. So depreciation account debit to machinery account would be our journal entry. Why machinery we are crediting? Because its value has decreased. Indirectly, it is something like a real account going away. Now, so how much is the value of depreciation? 3000. So we have to credit the machinery. So on the credit side, I am writing 3000 by constant, the reason being depreciation. The reason being depreciation, and the date being 16th. Now, usually this depreciation is calculated at the end of the year, but since it's a problem, we are given a date which is 16th. Now, next, on 22nd, we have a transaction, goods purchased from Swami. Now, when we have purchased goods from Swami, your journal entry would be purchases account debit to Swami's account. So when you write this journal entry, you see we are preparing machinery account. There is no mention of machinery. There will be no mention of machinery because machinery never gets affected in this transaction. So as far as problem is concerned, we are preparing only machinery account. We will not take this transaction into account. Now let us see again the last transaction, which is on 30th. Purchase of machinery for cash. Yes, it is purchase, but purchase of what? Machinery. So we are preparing machinery account, therefore this transaction affects machinery account. So our journal entry would be machinery to cash. So we are debiting machine in the journal entry. So on the debit side of machinery account, let us record the amount what we purchased. So 8,000. Then, you know, two constant, the reason you are getting machinery is in exchange of cash. So cash is the reason. So what's the date of the transaction? It is on 30th. So let us close the account now. Let us check both the sides total first. If we see, we have debit side 66,000. Roughly I'm writing debit, we have 66. And on credit, we have 11,000. Now let us take the difference, 55,000, okay. Now which side total is more? Debit side total. So you can put this total on both the sides. 66,000, because which total is more, we have to write that on both the sides. Now from 66, we are removing the credit side total, which is 11, so we are getting a difference of 55,000. That 55, we just write above the total column, and it is the balancing figure, we say that as by balance. Since we are closing the ledger, we will be using the word carried down. Generally, we close every account monthly. So it is the month of March. So the last date would be 31st March.